Hey everyone, this is BJ with Rogue Enterprises.
And Scott with Diprobo.
And today we're going to be shooting the Camaro that's behind us using the entire Halo EFX product line.
We're going to be doing the standard Halo EFX satin finish. We're going to start with our Covert black base and move on to our KP color shift pearl mixed in real clear.
Absolutely. We're going to try to be as thorough as possible in this video, give you guys as many tips and tricks as possible to help you guys in your projects at home. We may miss some things, so please, by all means, comment, ask questions, whatever you can do. We'll address them in the comments, or we'll make another video to help answer some of those other questions. Thanks so much. Obviously, we've masked off the entire car. Definitely, we taped off any areas we did not want sprayed. Any plastics or rubber pieces we've either removed or masked off. The car has been washed with a degreaser. The last step is just to give it a quick wipe down, make sure there's no surface contaminants. You can use denatured alcohol. I prefer personally a little bit more stronger prep spray. So we have a prep spray here. And I'm just going to quickly and lightly coat the surface. Use a microfiber towel and just wipe it down.
Be sure to get all the edges and any places that it's going to come in contact with the Halo EFX.
Okay, as you just saw, we already prepped the car, wiped it down, everything's ready to go. So we're getting ready to spray. We want to make sure that we're using the proper filters to go ahead and filter the product. That's with anything, that's pretty much par for the course. You want to make sure that you get any contaminants out before you get it into your hopper. We're going to be using the PPS cups, which come with a liner and a lid. That just helps for easy cleanup, and also you can turn your gun upside down and whatnot. It's not required, but it's my choice. So we're going to start with a gallon. This again, Covert Black Halo EFX. We've got the really handy pouring lid that's here. We're going to go ahead and pour it. So we've already mixed up this gallon really, really well, shaken, and then also blended with a stirring stick. And so that's ready to go. And now our cup is ready to go as well. Fix the lid. So we lock down the collar, ready to go. Always make sure that you have your respirator on because this stuff is pretty toxic. You don't want to be breathing that in. And then obviously I'm going to be using, my favorite gun is the Iwata LPH 400. It's basically what I use for all my base coats. It's actually a 1.8 tip. That sprays Halo wonderfully. You can use the smaller tips, but the 1.8 gives a fantastic finish. You can move pretty fast and get a lot of product on the car. So you can blow through gallons of product in a lot quicker time with a bigger tip. So again, I use the 1.8 tip, fix it right onto the lid, lock it in place, and it's good to go.
All right, so now we're just gonna jump right into it. We're gonna go ahead and start with our three tack coats using Covert Black.
Absolutely. I'm going to try to capture it from the point of view with the GoPro attached to my head. So hopefully you guys can keep up with the video. Again, three tack coats, and that's going to make sure that we have a nice base down before we start shooting wet to prevent any type of running or unwanted texture in the job. Okay, so I've just finished the three tack coats on the car. And just to reiterate, what a tack coat is I've closed off on the gun the flow. So I've actually tightened it down so that less product is actually coming out of the gun, and I'm moving quick. So it's a very, very light dust coat on the car. I went around three times, and after three times, you still get a dark black, but it's just a little bit slower process. Take your time, move quickly around the car, and get it very, very light coverage each time to build up to a dark black.
So now we're going to go ahead and show you a nice little quick pro tip about how you can use a 50-50 mix of denatured alcohol and water in order to wipe off any overspray and anything that might have fallen on the car during time spraying. What this does almost is like a super mild wet sand almost, and it takes off any kind of debris, any nibs that maybe have fallen in during these tack coats.
Absolutely. This is a fantastic tip when you're spraying in a garage, for example, because of the dust in the air. Anything that falls in the vehicle, your microfiber is going to catch it, you're going to feel it, and you're going to be able to wipe it away with the water and denatured alcohol mix. Big, big tip that I got from Kevin Hibbs over at Dip & Coat 318. Fantastic.
Alright, so we've gone ahead and we've gotten our tack coats down. And this again is just our three light coats, and we progressively use more product per pass. Now we're getting ready to shoot the car wet.
Exactly, so that means we're going to turn the gun up. Essentially with my gun, and with most guns, there's two knobs. One for the fan and one for the product flow. So the fan, I leave the same. The product flow is what I crank open and allow more product to come out of the gun. For my dust coats, I crank it down and close it off so that less product's coming out. And for the wet coats, I open it up, allow a lot more product to come out, which allows me to maintain a steady rhythm.
Okay, so after our fourth coat, you can see the satin sheen of this dark black base is really coming through. We have full coverage on the vehicle. We're going to go ahead and hit it with another coat after we wipe the car down with our denatured alcohol and water mix. Alright, so now that we've achieved our base coat, we're ready to move on to our pearl coats. And today I've selected a Vanguard Color Shift and an Omega Nano Color Shift, both available at kppigments.com. Now I've selected 50 grams over 1.5 gallons, and now this might seem like a low pearl load. This is going to give us a great even finish on this vehicle. I've always used a xylene reduction. This is very important when it comes to pro coats. You want to do about 10 to 15% per gallon. And the reason for this is that it reduces striping and it reduces pearl buildup. And this allows for a very perfect uniform finish.
so here we have the finished product right behind us. Came out great. Again, we used the Halo EFX product line, and we used pearls from KP Pigments, color shift pearls. It came out beautifully. One thing we did on the last coat was do a xylene reduction on the Real Clear to lock it all in, and the xylene added helps to wet it out a little better. Not necessary, but it's something I like to do. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and we'll see you next time.
Also, one thing we were able to accomplish while we sprayed this car is we were able to spray these wheels in gloss black using True Gloss from Halo EFX. We'd like to give you a step-by-step tutorial on how to do that in our next video, so please subscribe.